Well, it's finally here. Version 2, all apps, all platforms, no subscription. This is Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to dive deep into Affinity's huge new update for version 2. Version 2 is here. That's right, version 2. For all apps across all platforms. So we now have a publisher app for the iPad, which I know a lot of people were kind of expecting and they've been talking about for some time. But along with the upgrade to version 2, you can also snag the universal license, which gives you access to all three apps, Photo, Designer, and Publisher on all platforms. So you have access to them on iPad, Mac, or Windows. This is a great option to get all three, especially while they are discounted. But now let's take a closer look at each app and the new updates and features. All right, so let's kick it off with Affinity Photo. Let's scroll through here and take a look. So here they are just kind of talking about what we've come to know and appreciate with Affinity Photo, the different features that they have, including their brush library. But if we come down here, talk a little bit more about their new additions and updates. So down here, for instance, they are adding assets. You can save a library of assets to speed up your workflow. They have also added additional blend modes. You could create the perfect look for your project by experimenting with a range of blend modes. They also have incorporated a live mesh warp, which I think this is a pretty cool feature. And you could apply a non-destructive warp to distort an image or file to match the surface of an underlying template and go back to edit whenever you like. So focus merge, merging images with different focus differences for greater depth of field. They're also introducing compound masks, easily combined multiple mask layers together non-destructively using add, intersect, subtract, and XOR operations. They're instituting live masks as well. Build useful non-destructive workflows by masking layers with parametric controls such as hue range, luminosity, and bandpass. So some cool new features added to Affinity Photo. Some I think people will be pretty excited about, and I also think some pretty useful ones as well that'll be fun to play around with. Let's go ahead and hop over to Publisher. So taking a look at Affinity Publisher 2, one of the biggest updates for Publisher 2 would be the fact that it is available now on iPad. That's something they've been talking about for a little while now, so that's pretty cool. Now we have the full Affinity suite on iPad. So let's go ahead and scroll down to the section here where they talk about some of the new features added to Publisher in version 2. We've got a new place auto flow. Create a single layout that automatically repeats across your document until all desired images are accommodated. Master pages. Work with live master pages, including nested and smart master pages. Path text. Explore a range of diverse typographical designs by adding text along a path. Style picker tool. Quickly apply the style of any object or text on your page to another. That seems like a very helpful feature and time-saving for sure. Footnotes, endnotes, and side notes. Add academic style notes or references to sections of text. Open type support. Make the most of your typography and experiment with expanded character sets. And books. Combine separate publisher documents as chapters to create one long publication, automatically seeking page numbers, table contents, indexes, and styles throughout. So that seems like a pretty cool feature to be added as well. So let's go ahead and hop over to Designer. Right, last and certainly not least is Affinity Designer 2. Now this is the app that I was the most excited about. This is the app I use the most for all of my illustration and design work, as you all know. I've got tons of videos up on different aspects of Affinity Designer. So I'm very excited about the new updates and features. So let's go ahead and talk about some of the stuff that they've added. All right, so what we've got here right off the bat is a vector warp. Apply non-destructive vector warp over any vector artwork or text. Editing any warp offers a super fast live preview, even on complex illustrations, and gives a true vector end result. This is pretty cool. I was playing around with this just a little bit a while ago, and they even have a cool perspective feature. So I think this is something that'll be really neat to incorporate into some illustration and design work. We also have an enhanced and upgraded contour tool. Create abstract objects or increase the width of a single open curves with powerful contour tool. This will be another really fun feature to mess around with and play with. They've also introduced non-destructive adjustments. There are a range of adjustments which can be applied to your design as a new layer for creative or corrective purposes. We now have X-ray view, a new view mode to show the makeup of your work, particularly useful for targeted selection of a specific curve object within complex artwork. Now this does come in handy when you do create artwork with lots of layers. You could use X-ray mode to better make selections on various layers without getting things confused. We also have, which is super cool, and I know a lot of people have been really excited about, a full shape builder tool has been added to Affinity Designer. You can add and subtract shapes and segments in an easy, interactive way. Simply drag to combine or hold to subtract. So this is an awesome feature. I will certainly be breaking this down a lot more in its own video. Enhancements to grids and guides. You can set up grids and guides almost any way you want, whether it's a standard grid pattern or full isometric with multiple planes. Another super cool feature I'm looking forward to diving into more. We also have a knife tool. Slice any shape, curve, or text into component parts incredibly fast. Well, this is exciting. Version 2 is finally here. I will be breaking down each new feature, especially for Affinity Designer, in more detail in upcoming videos. So like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss any new videos. Thanks for watching, and until next time.